Hi, this is Rick Rise from HighDefColor.com. Today we're going to talk about the CMYK color space and the two most common CMYK color profiles. It's important to note that a color profile is a behavior or the characteristics of a printing condition. So it's important to note that when dealing with your commercial printer, to ask them which color profile or which color specification they print to and to use that profile. Here at HighDefColor.com, we support the Grackle color specification. The important thing to note is you're actually looking at a CMYK color model that's plotted in the LAV color space. The LAV color space is a three-axis determination of what a color is going to be, so it's absolute. The first axis is the L channel, or the lightness, which goes from white to black. Now that is going from top to bottom, and it's also important to note that this along this axis is where your grays are going to be, your gray balance, your 50% gray, 75, 25, and so on, are going to be right down the center of that axis. The second axis, the A axis, goes from a cyan green over to a magenta red color, and the B axis goes from a blue to a yellow. So within this area here is where we're going to plot all of our colors. We're going to go from our lightest colors up here to our darker colors down here. So in the center is where all your neutral colors are going to be. So we'll start with our first color profile. That will be the SWOP color profile. And we're going to turn that on, and you can see we've generated a three-dimensional wireframe of that color model. We're going to go from our paper white down to our shadows, and then across from our primary colors, our reds, our blues, and our greens, to our subtractive primaries, our yellow, cyan, and magenta. And from the top down, looking straight down, you can see that we've plotted the outside circumference of our color space, so we can see our color a little better along with our three-dimensional wireframe. The second option is the Grackle color profile. Now I'm going to bring that in. You'll notice that when I click this on, that the Grackle color profile completely engulfs the SWOP color profile. And looking down here at the bottom, if you follow the cursor, you'll notice from the top down, the shadow or the circumference is much larger than the SWOP color gamut, meaning that you have more color that's accessible when you convert from RGB to CMYK. So you're going to get a larger color gamut, and this is displaying graphically what the larger color gamut is with the Grackle profile. And again, it's important to note that you can't just choose a profile. You got to understand what profile or what specifications your printer is running to. So if you convert to a SWOP profile and you're printing on Grackle, there's going to be different results. So again, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change the opacity of the Grackle so you can see better how much more color is available, resulting in a larger color gamut. And we'll get this spin in here so you can look around the different colors. And again, look at the top down and then also look at the wireframe to see how much more color, there's more volume of color for you to work with to get a better reproduction in CMYK when you convert from RGB.